Hi friends, how are you feeling? Are you feeling panicked? Are you gripped with fear? Are you losing hope? Are you all the time discussing about what future is going to be like? Are you all the time looking at the news? How many cases have happened? Is it going to help? Losing hope is going to help. We meet with so many things, disasters in life, some accidents. I had fire in my factory twice. Big disaster. But did I stop looking at the future? Was I always fearful or hopeless? Or I was scared to continue with it? No. There's a word called reconstruction. So Thomas Edison is very famous for this word. When he was 67 years of age, his lab got major fire. And his son Charles, you know, he was searching for him. Where is he? Where is his father? So he thought he was in lab. He was scared, you know. So, and then he saw his father coming. And his father told, "Where is your mom? And please call her. And please tell her to call her friends." So the son was surprised. Why? You know, ultimately he told that I want to show them this fire. They will never be able to see this kind of sight in life. So I will rebuild. And the, you know, next day, that night, he slept folding his coat on one table. And next day, early morning, 5 o'clock, he called his team. He called some machinery person who would get the machine. He started selling the rubbish, the scrap, and he was laughing. He said, "I can make money out of this scrap also." And his son has written a book, The Electric Thomas Edison. So he has mentioned this incident. And after that, he did so many researches. He did inventions, great inventions for which he is known for, right? So this is what we can do. So let's not keep wondering what will happen tomorrow. Let's start working what I can do today, thinking what I can do today. How do you get up in the morning? With no hope, no agenda, no targets. Friends, please don't do that. Get up in the morning, do your exercises, do some meditation, make a list, get ready as usual, and then make a list what you can do today. Make a timetable. I'm going to read a book. I'm going to write a journal. I'm going to educate myself on some YouTube channel. I'm going to write a blog. I'm going to learn a new skill. I'll enroll myself for some online course. I will empower people through my motivational speech. I will interact, make a social circle. I'll interact with children. I will give them some activities. I started this. I started some competition for kids, youth, housewives, anybody. They will write a poem. They'll write a, you know, maybe some blog or some story. What they did during this corona period. How they are learning. How they are developing themselves. How they want to make this a very memorable event of their life. After, you know, this gets over, it is going to get over, right? So after this gets over, they can remember what they created in this period, how they developed themselves, some skills, which will help them for all their life. Or we want to feel paralytic and just lie down, keep eating, and then regret for all our life. For the future, I don't think so. We should do that. Many disasters happen, but there is always an end to it. And revival may take time, but it's beautiful. One thing which this disaster has taught us, that how we all are connected. So, you know, something happening in China, small virus, invisible, but it has impacted the whole world. So let's connect with each other. Let's love each other. Let's treasure each other.